Hello again. Max Vermorken of SigmaRoc joins us at the Proactive Investor Studio here in London. Very warm welcome to you, Max. Great to see you once again. And terrific news to tell investors about as well, this new £15 million acquisition. What are the details on that?
Yes, we're very happy about that. We acquire a group called CCP Building Products Group. It's based in and around Liverpool and Manchester. It's a concrete products and quarrying business, and it fits very nicely with a platform number two we created at the end of last year called PPG, which is basically Precast Products Group. Now, the business consists of four production sites and a trading division, two very modern, fully automated block facilities, a slag facility, a 40 million ton reserve quarry, all very nicely integrated, which has been built over the last 10 years. It's a great business for us.
Before we go on to how that works and the regions that you're operating in and what you want to concentrate on, tell us about how that goes together with the debt facilities.
So basically, there's a whole bunch of news that we're putting out today. It's actually in a number of updates to the market on what we've achieved recently. So the CCP acquisition is obviously one part, and then the second part is that we have received an offer from Ravenscroft Group to refinance our convertible loan notes. Which is a facility we have, or an instrument we had in the market for since our listing initially. And it's actually a really nice combination of news, because it's a strong signal from our shareholders, who are also the convertible loan note holders, that they continue to support the growth of our business and are happy to redeem those notes and continue our...
It's a sign of great confidence, essentially,
absolutely,
isn't
absolutely.
It?
Absolutely, absolutely. And we've worked with Santander Bank, which is the provider of our term loan facilities, to refinance that structure. So as soon as all of that's in place and the details are actually available for the market, we'll tell the markets about it. But it's very much a combination of various aspects that positions us as a business very strongly for the next year.
All right, well, let's go back to that main news that you came in with then, that new acquisition, yep. £15 million acquisition. Mm-hmm. You've explained why it's strong. It's interesting hearing about that, because it's very similar vertically in its nature to the business that you run in the Channel Islands. You, of course, concentrated in Channel Islands and east of England.
Yes, correct. So we've got two platforms to date, and platforms are a group of companies which fit nicely together, and we run them as quasi standalone entities run by one managing director locally. And so platform number one was the Channel Islands, and platform number two started in East Anglia, focused primarily on concrete products. Obviously geographically fairly isolated down in the southeast, the new group CCP allows that platform to now expand across the country. Also from a product perspective, what we do in the southeast and what we will be doing in the northwest are completely different products.
Let's talk about that region then. So that new region that you're going to be concentrating on is the northwest,
correct?
And part of Wales as well.
Correct.
Why have you targeted or thought that area is a good area for your business growth?
It's a great hub. Liverpool, Manchester, there's a lot of activity. You've got the M6 corridor down to Birmingham, quite a bit of activity that way, and then the M6 corridor up above Manchester as well, and then North Wales falls into that sort of same geographic area. There's plenty of activity there, plenty of infrastructure coming through. HS2 will pass through there, so I'm very, very confident about the prospects of that whole area.
But what about saturation? Isn't there already enough providers there? Aren't there already enough providers?
We are in a sector where there's always plenty of providers, but that's the beauty of the company we're buying. They started out with a fairly small one-site operation in 2006, and have grown through acquisition, a bit like we do ourselves, over the last 10 years to capture more than 20% of market share through acquisition, through growth, through modernization, by just being the supplier of choice, a quality product, well manufactured and supplied on time.
And proximity to customer is
correct.
Key to your strategy, isn't it?
Correct, exactly. And so that plus the trading business they've got, plus the fact that they're vertically integrated, all of these aspects just fit very nicely with us. Now, the other beauty of it is the management team stays with it. The people that founded the company will stay with us for the next 3 years. And so as a consequence of that, the growth that we've seen in this company, I'm very confident that we'll see that growth continue.
Well, talking of growth, your growth revenues have been particularly impressive, not just because you've made money, but also because it hangs against the backdrop of a fairly smarting construction business, which hasn't been doing very well over the last few months.
The markets have been flat in some areas in the country, or have in some areas maybe declined a bit. We are very, very focused in where we operate, first of all. And secondly, we've got this strategy of improvement of companies we acquire. So that improvement typically helps us generate much more profitability out of the businesses we buy. then the fact that we're much more close to customers than most suppliers because of the business model we run means that very often customers are very satisfied with what we offer them. So all of these things help us drive profitability, and then you can see that the numbers that come out for sure till October this year are fairly strong.
Now, you've just been at the investors show, Mello, haven't you? That was your first time to introduce yourself mm-hmm. to many who hadn't heard of SigmaRoc and what you do. Now you'd like to follow that up with continuing your story and continuing your growth.
Yes, so it's always very important to us to engage not only with the bigger institutional investors we've got, but also with private investors who would attend Mello and others in the UK Investor Show and so on. So we're quite happy to do a two-day presentation there, have a stand on that show, and we'll continue to do that and be present at such events. So if private investors want to come and see us and have a chat about what we're doing, we'll be around.
And were you able to give a trading update on the back of that?
Well, the trading update is basically what we published this morning. That's the numbers up to the end of October.
Were you there? Were you able to do that at Mello?
No, at Mello, we gave the investors a general overview of what we've achieved based on the half-year numbers which came out in September, which were very strong numbers. And I'm very happy that with the update from this morning, we can continue that same story.
So great to get that update for investors mm-hmm. this morning. And in terms of the next four quarters, 2019, what are you looking to roll out? Any new other acquisitions on the horizon?
There's plenty of projects we look at. We've got a shareholder meeting organized for the end of this month, where we will ask for a little bit more authorities to issue some more shares than just for the most recent acquisition, just to be in a good position to be able to act on new opportunities you will find. 2019 may be a tricky year, as obviously Brexit in March, but in general we're very, very optimistic about what we can achieve. The model we've run fundamentally, it depends obviously on continued demand for construction materials, but it also depends very much on how we operate and integrate and improve companies. And we buy very high quality businesses. So we continue to do those things in parallel, and we should be in a good position for a good year.
Max Vermorken, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.